Hi. In this video, we look together at various interpretation and pedaling options in the two cadenzas from Liszt's Liebestraum No. 3 and two cadenzas from Liszt's Un Sospiro, which are equally familiar to you and share interpretational similarities. The practical side of playing the Liszt cadenzas is covered in related tutorials linked below. If two pedals are available to you on your piano, that's to say una corda and sustain, these cadenzas will probably sound at their best without pedal, as indicated on the score. This doesn't necessarily mean they can only be played without pedal, as today we have new pedals not available to Liszt in 1850 when Liebestraum was first published. In the following cadenza examples, I've chosen to use the new harmonic pedal. For those interested to know how this pedal works, I've linked harmonic pedal channels in the video info box below. I'll start by playing the two cadenzas from Un Sospiro. I'll play them for comparison side by side without pedal and with the harmonic pedal in resonance half position, which will add an extra harmonic colour from the piano itself while preserving the clarity associated with playing without pedal. So here's the cadenzas from Un Sospiro. And now the cadenzas from Liebestraum. The style of piano playing approximately 150 years ago, when Liszt was writing his music, was probably a little different to the piano style of today. For instance, pianists often improvised on stage to a theme given on the spur of the moment by the audience. Cadenzas were often improvised freely, and they gave pianists like Liszt an opportunity to show off their virtuoso skills at the keyboard. Godowsky, in his 1925 Liebestraum recording on YouTube at the time of making this video, gives us a glimpse at the performing style of his time and also the time before recordings. Godowsky adds his own variation to Cadenza 2. Here it is. I haven't been able to find the Godowsky cadenza written down, so I'll attempt to improvise something similar, and you might want to do the same. I'm guessing Godowsky adds a scale in the left hand, like this. In the following five examples, the resonance of the E flat 7 spread chord is held with the harmonic pedals sostenuto throughout the chromatic run. The chromatic run is played with the harmonic pedals resonance position over this held E flat 7 chord. The chord is released in the second part of the cadenza, which is played with resonance alone to the end. I'll round off this video with a description by Berlioz. He said of Liszt's playing, Liszt would add cadenzas, tremolos and trills when playing the first movement of Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata, and created a dramatic scene by changing the tempo between largo and presto. Liszt confessed regretfully to George Sand in a letter he had done so for the purpose of gaining applause, and promised her to follow the score just as written from then on. Which in a way describes the way we approach piano works today. Thanks for watching.